Ryuko abandons her Kamui Senketsu, and Nudist Beach goes to war with Hinoji Academy, in my review of Kill la Kill, episode 20. Going into this week's episode, I was really ready to hate this one, and I only say that because at the end of last week's episode, Ryuko was having a real shitty attitude with everybody. She was dismissing Nudist Beach, she stopped being friends with Mako, and she completely abandoned Senketsu, and that's where they pick up this week, and I'm glad to say that my fears were alleviated, because at the end of this week's episode, there is a really, really nice plot twist, but there's an assload of build-up to it, so let's just go ahead and take a big, badass bite right in. First and foremost, nice touch, in the intro, they actually showed that the members of the Elite Four, typically when they're going through the lineup, they show all the different costumes that they were wearing, and they added their Nudist Beach costumes this week, which was a really nice touch. But right after that, we immediately open up the episode where Ryuko is being attacked by these weird manifestation life fibers of Nui and Ragyo, and they're transforming, and they turn their hands into these, like, paper drills and shit. It's pretty weird. But basically, this is just to bait Ryuko and try to get her to come to Hinoji Academy, which she does, and she does so in style. She freaking takes this big-ass purple motorcycle and rides off into the sun. It's a very beautiful image. And honestly, I'm glad they didn't focus too much on Ryuko just moping around too much, not doing what they did in Gurren Lagann by showing Simone be a little bitch for a couple episodes because his best buddy died. By the way, if you haven't seen Gurren Lagann, check it out. Best mecha series ever. Better than your mom. All the stuff with Nudist Beach this week was really cool. It looks like they're actually building up for the final battle of the series, and I can't believe it's already happening this early. But it's really cool because Nudist Beach has a lot of secret weapons that have been funded by Takarada. If you don't remember who he is, he's the guy who Sanagiyama artificially inseminated with his bamboo sword. Check that episode out. It's both funny and badass. But what's cool here is they have this big badass battleship, which is called the SS Naked Sun. And I just can't help but be reminded of the giant ship from Gurren Lagann. It has the sharp edges and everything, and it resembles it quite a bit. Except, unlike being a giant robot, this one is actually a ship. It goes on the water, and it contains a lot of really cool weapons, including the entire freaking Nudist Beach army, which now includes Mako and her family with uniforms, which looks very, very funny. When Ryuko actually arrives to Hinoji Academy, she immediately starts tearing up all of the suits. I especially like the entrance she made, which was a nice callback to when she first went to Hinoji Academy on Don't Be Late Day, when she arrives in the trolley, which just explodes in the middle of the square of the school. And this is when she's confronted by Nui Harime, and they have a short fight. And this is also where we get the confirmation that Nui Harime is indeed a human life fiber hybrid, because she rips her own damn heart out. And the reveal to it was really awesome. I actually thought that maybe Ryuko actually was going to defeat her at first, the way she, like, wrapped this cloth around her head, pulled Nui towards her, and stabbed right through her. I thought that was very shocking, but the minute she started laughing, you just knew that there was going to be a twist like that. And this is when they actually capture Ryuko with these weird life fiber threads. And this is where the biggest plot twist of the episode comes in, and it's really great. Ragyo Kiryuin has big plans for her daughter, and that includes making her wear the Junketsu, and I think that's a great plot twist, and it looks great on Ryuko. I do like the fact that whenever different characters wear the different Kamui suits, it does change oh so slightly when they go through the transformation. You can see that when Ryuko goes into the transformation with her Junketsu suit, the way she looks, she has like these horns and this big skirt, and she looks evil as hell. I also like the touch that the back of her hair is now colored blue as opposed to red, just to really show the complete difference and to show that it really goes color scheme-wise with the Junketsu suit. But before they actually get to that, all the people from Nudist Beach attack Hinoji Academy, and this big action scene ensues, which also includes Satsuki escaping from jail because she has been sharpening her freaking toenail, and she's just running around this place completely naked and shackled up, tearing up all of the covers and tuxedos. And it's a great scene, and it's just really funny looking and quite titillating. But I really do like the scene where she is confronted by all the Elite Four members and they all are finally joined together. It's kind of like the scene in The Avengers where all the heroes are finally like together at the end of the movie and they do like a big panoram shot. Just the shot where they all come down from the helicopter and they're all finally together again. I don't know, just something about that scene really gave me goosebumps. But speaking of goosebumps, at the very end of the episode, the biggest plot twist comes when it looks like Nudist Beach is about to be attacked by a big secret weapon, and it is indeed Ryuko wearing the Junketsu suit, and they have no choice but to fight against her. And you even have Sumagu, who's in his powered-up DTR robot, which is green and has all these missiles, but it really doesn't do anything. He even fires at Ryuko at, like, point-blank range, and it doesn't do shit. But this is when the best part of the episode comes into play for me, and that's when Satsuki decides she is going to fight against Ryuko, but she's not going to be alone. Satsuki is going to be wearing Senketsu, and she's going to be using her two broken swords to fight against Ryuko, who is wearing Junketsu. The twist is awesome. Satsuki looks incredible in the Senketsu suit. If I may say, she looks sexy as all hell. This was another awesome episode of Kill la Kill, which featured everything I love about the series. Its ability to not take itself too seriously, its incredible animation, its fantastic musical cues, and its explosive, badass, and brutal action. It's unlike any series I've ever seen before, and just like its brethren Gurren Lagann, it's paving the way for even more creative anime series, and I cannot wait to see more from this studio in the future. My favorite thing about this episode is the fact that both Ryuko and Satsuki are actually going to be switching uniforms. Just something about that is really intriguing to me. And, you know, I know eventually that Ryuko is going to be snapped out of this weird funk that she's in right now, but for the time being, I'm just going to sort of try to sit back and enjoy it, but I hope they don't drag it out for too long, because I don't know how many more episodes are left of the series, but there can't be too many more, because I know they're not going to drag this one out too much. But the good thing about this series is every single episode pretty much feels important, and every episode has something really cool about it. And this episode, again, is no exception. It has a lot of really cool plot twists, all the stuff you would expect from the rest of the series. So follow this one. I'm giving it a 10 out of 10. I thought it was incredible. It was just another badass, sexy, explosive, awesome episode of Kill la Kill. Check it out, guys. You will not be disappointed. So if you guys had a chance to check out this week's episode of Kill la Kill, it's time to let me know what you thought about it with your comments below. Please tell me about your favorite moments, maybe some stuff you didn't care for, and who is going to win in the battle with Satsuki and Senketsu and Ryuko and Junketsu. Oh, it's going to be awesome. Remember, guys, before you leave, hit the like button. Give this video a thumbs up. It's one of the easiest ways to support our videos. And you can subscribe, check out our Facebook and our Twitter. It's all in the description box below. So I'll see you next time, guys. Super Kami Guru 9000. Out.